In this video, I'm going to show you how to create multiple default sets in Ableton so you can get to work right away as soon as Ableton opens up. No remapping, no dragging in the same sounds over and over, and most importantly, no delay when you are ready to start making music. Brett Pontecorvo here at livekeyboardist.com, where I teach keyboard players just like you the ins and outs of Ableton, sound design, and live performance techniques. If you're new here, please consider hitting that like and subscribe button. But today we're talking about templates, so let's jump in. First of all, a template should always include these three things. First of all, whatever sounds you use all the time, whatever effects you use all the time, that should be in your template. Secondly, whatever levels you have altered on them. So if you know one sound is particularly loud, save that as a slightly lower volume in your template. And lastly, any mappings that you want to include. So if you've got some volumes you want controlled with a specific button on your controller, throw that in your template so you never have to remap it again. Now let's check out how to actually save it as a template. So when you open up Ableton, you get a default set. And this is my default set. It's got just a piano, an on-off button, and a volume button. It's really simple, but I teach a lot of piano lessons. And so when I do this, I just want a piano sound, and also I'm a piano player. So if I'm recreationally playing, this is all I want. So once you've created your setup, whatever it is that you want to have when it opens, all you have to do is go up here, choose Preferences, choose File Folder, and just click Save Current Set as Default. Overwrite the default set, okay, and that's it. Now when you open Ableton, this will open, but Ableton actually allows you to create multiple default sets, and this is really cool because it's going to open up a robust set that is untitled, so you can easily save it anywhere. And I have a couple of those, and this is how it's done. So in your user library, you'll need to create a folder called Templates. So if you move over to your browser and choose User Library, you can just right mouse click and choose New Folder, type in Templates, capital T, and that's that. Now, I already have this folder here. I've got two different templates here. But let's say I want to save this as a new template, right? So we gotta locate our user library. So if we go into our preferences, you're gonna see that under your library, it's gonna tell you your location of the user library. Volumes, samples, live, user library. So if this is, well, let's add some things here. Maybe I added an operator. Maybe I added a simpler over here. Maybe I changed this way. Maybe there's wavetable as well. Now we're just gonna save it. So we'll go File, Save Live Set As, and we have to find our user library. So for me, I'm just gonna go samples, live, user library, and here's my templates folder. Now I can save this as demo template, and I'll hit save. And you'll notice this is still untitled, right? When I come down here to my user library, if I double click it, it's gonna open up what I created as a default template. Or I could open up any other of these templates, and it will still be labeled as untitled, so you can get to work right away. Now, if you're building a default template because you want to improve your workflow, I encourage you to check out this video that's going to give you some time-saving tips. And right along those lines, this video is going to show you my 11 most used keyboard shortcuts. Please consider liking and subscribing before you go, and I will see you next time on livekeyboardist.com.